Hey guys, welcome back. If I sound a little bit different today, I apologize. I'm not at my house around all my own stuff. I'm in Toronto, and you can tell because if you listen carefully, you can hear the faint whisper of sirens going to pick up the day's criminals. I'm just kidding. I love Toronto. But it doesn't matter. Anyway, today I'm going to show you how to make 128s. If you don't know what 128s are, well, we're going to make one, but first I'll show you what it is. It's, well, the quick and easy version to know is that you can, for example, load up an ass load of hi-hat samples, okay? If you're looking for a sample, this is like a specific thing, and you have 2 million hi-hats, but you want to just be able to turn a knob and keep listening until you hear it, this is how you do it. See, for example, if I'm hitting the hi-hat, I can move this and it just cycles through all kinds of the hi-hat samples. And that's handy because then I can have my hi-hat inside my track and then I can just turn a knob on my MIDI controller or just move this up and down until I find the sample I want and let go and bam, you're done. Okay? Instead of going to here and finding it and loading it and all this crap, just don't worry about that. Don't do that. I'm going to show you how to set this up. Okay? All right, buckle in and let's get started. Okay, so you might recognize this. Sorry, I had to leave for a sec and reset this up. You might recognize this song from my last video, but I want you to have another quick listen and just tell me what you recognize when you hear these hats, okay? All right. See, there's some movement in the hats, and it might not sound all that appealing, but this is just a demonstration of something that you can do. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is create that 128 that I was talking about. So click the plus symbol to add in another MIDI instrument, go to Bitwig, and choose drum machine. Nothing crazy. And then find where your hat's going to exist. Me, so I'll just put it on here. Okay, so this is going to be my close hi-hat. So yeah, so you're going to click plus and you're going to find the sampler, okay? The Bitwig sampler. Where are you? Right there, okay? Now, you're going to right click here and create new sample and then edit multi-sample. So now you've basically just put a sampler on here and you're telling it that you're going to load this up with an ass load of samples, okay? Go to your samples browser part and type in hat or whatever you got, wherever the range of hi-hats that you want to add exists. I'm going to go like this and I'm just going to grab like that many. Okay. Bring them in here. See, notice if my mouse is too low, I haven't let go of the mouse button, by the way. If it's low, it's like for some reason thicker, meaning it's taking up multiple notes per sample. So go above the halfway point and now you see it's just one sample per note. So there you go. There you have that. Now you're going to add in, click the plus sign where it's blue right there, and where is it? Note pitch shifter. Okay. So now, you'll notice as I change the semitones, it cycles through all the samples that I've played on there. And that's pretty much it. Just keep loading up the sampler with more samples of your closed hi-hat. And then as you move this up and down, you'll get to play through all the different samples. And that's basically all there is to it. So you can make one of these, you can put one of these for your closed hi-hats, open hi-hats, your kicks, your snares. And then that way, when you are listening to your track, you can just kind of go in here and scroll up and down until you find just the perfect sample for your song, okay? All right, so now you're wondering, how did I get movement inside here? Well, that's pretty easy. I'll delete that. So here's one that I've already got set up, okay? I have my multi-sampler here, and there's the thing that we installed on it. So if I move that up and down now, I'll get different samples. What I did though, was I clicked plus. I'll delete this even. I clicked plus, chose the LFO, like so. Open the LFO settings. I changed it to free because I don't want it to re-trigger every time I hit a note. I chose this. I click this so that I'm starting to mod things, and I just drag this up a range. So now, as it's playing, this thing is automatically cycling through a whole ton of the samples, okay? And that's how we get that sound. Before I forget, let me just point out that this course actually controls the semitones. I don't know why they didn't call it semitones, but that's besides the point. So you could right-click on this, map it to a knob on your MIDI controller, and now that knob will control these. So now while you listen to it, you can use that knob to adjust the sample. See? And that's good if you're trying to search for just the right sample, the right hi-hat sample. Then you wouldn't have to come in here with a mouse and do it. You would just have it on your controller. And I don't know if that's any more convenient or not, but it's something to think about. Okay? So it's not all that appealing of a song, but you could see how that could become useful. Okay? All right, so do that up. Make a whole bunch of your own drum patches. Leave some comments and questions if you have any. You can email me directly and click subscribe down below. All right, take care.